So when did you two start skateboarding?
4 years ago.
3 years ago.
Why?
Why wouldn't you, man? Look how cool it is. Beautiful, mate. Fucking beautiful.
That is, it's sick. It's freedom.
Freedom?
Yeah.
What else is skateboarding to you?
Skateboarding's everything, mate. All we do is skate.
If I didn't skate, I wouldn't have like half the friends I have today.
Definitely.
Literally.
Yeah.
Skateboarding. To some, it's a sport. To others, a hobby or a pastime or even a nuisance. But to some, it's a passion, a love and a lifestyle. But things are changing. Skateboarding used to be something of an unknown outside of America. Sure, everybody knew what a skateboard was, but not many people practiced it. In recent times, more and more people are joining the wood pusher ranks, with an estimated number of around 120,000 frequent participants, compared to around only 35,000 in 1995. And whilst this brings its share of money, parks, and more importantly, coverage to the UK, it also brings problems. This documentary is focused around a group of devoted skateboarders, aged 15 to 20 in the Stourbridge area, West Midlands, England, and their lifestyle, experiences, and problems. Stourbridge is a fairly average town nestled in the centre of the West Midlands, approximately 15 miles from the huge city of Birmingham. Birmingham is one of the UK's largest skate scenes, and due to this, Stourbridge has an unusually large number of skateboarders, which I from experience would estimate to be around 100. However, despite this popularity of the sport, skateboarding in Stourbridge appears to be running out of time. A police officer who does not wish to be named admitted to a campaign to prevent skateboarders from causing a nuisance to the public and to prevent them from practicing around the town centre. While this may seem fair enough on the surface of it, this campaign does not take into account the lack of any indoor skate parks, with only one tiny park in the whole of Stourbridge prone to vandalism by non-skaters. An indoor park was closed by the council 5 years ago and has lied abandoned ever since. With police patrolling multi-stories and other indoor areas, and the council refusing to supply any funding for the cause, skaters have nowhere to go on the cold, wet, dark winter nights, and have to settle with skating an empty and dirty factory unit that was abandoned after an arson attack.
Right now it's at factory, it's abandoned factory where you can skate and it's chill, man. But it's not really nice to space, but skate, chill, man. So it's cool, but this place used to be... No, I can't do it right.
What did this used to be?
Like some steelworks, didn't it?
They've still got all the beams where the crane goes.
But now it's just abandoned and we...
people have... shit, because of biking!
People have cleaned up and skateboarding up.
With so few skate spots around town, day trips are becoming more and more popular. But Stourbridge isn't the only place that's putting anti-skateboarder plans into action.
We're at Bowl. It used to be quite a nice warm-up spot. We just get straight off the train at Snow Hill and then come straight here before we went to the other spots. Until we got the ledges, all the ledges got capped.
Spot out of fun, really. Prime example of the council and the authorities not understanding we're not really doing anything wrong.
I put them on like every single...
And this is only one of many places, not only throughout Birmingham, but throughout the whole of the UK, where a war on skateboarding is being fought behind the scenes. To try and find out more, I talked to a local security guard about his opinions and experiences on skateboarding.
To a certain extent, yes. Yes, I'm always having to stop them riding through the center. Well, it depends what you class as antisocial. Personally, I would say that getting in the way and generally congregating in my centre is antisocial behaviour. But other than that, I can't say that they do.
Yes, we have, yes. Shouldn't be allowed in the built-up area, pedestrian-wise area.
So with police, security and even general public holding a somewhat uninformed grudge against skateboarders, the situation isn't looking too bright. But skateboarders, by tradition, never give up. And with talks beginning February 2012 to build a new indoor park, and summer on the way, maybe things could still turn around. But one thing is for certain, the Stourbridge boys aren't going down without a fight.
Let them know.